Hi, I'm Chris. In this video series, we will talk about the Ready to Educate cell. And in this first video, I will show you how to define the home position for your robot. Let's go.
We're going to use a template that is already in the public models KUKA.Sim library. And if you go there to tutorials, you can jump to the section 40 create a program. If you click on layout and open the side view here, you can go on the lower left model here. Actually, there is a backup of every step that we're going to look at, but we're going to look at the one out. So if you hover on it, you see the path where this model is lying, and actually there is nothing at the end. Here is a step number 3, but we want the basic starting point. So if we double click here on this model, it will generate in the origin of our simulation. From there on, we will start to work and to actually first do set up the tool data and then the home position and then write a little program. So what we're going to do first, if we click on the robot and go to the program tab here, you can see that the home position is now set to this cannon mode. So axis 2 is at minus 90 degrees and axis 3 is at 90 degrees. Well, this is actually not the way normally a home position is generally defined. It's the default mode here, but we want to change this. And for that, we usually use directly the tool. It's already written in it, but as you can see, it's still on the flange. So we want to use the real tool data one, which is between our gripper. And therefore we select tool data one and we go on this little gear, and from there on we jump to the gripper, and we actually snap now this tool data one to the in between our two gripper jaws. So if we go here, we select the midpoint, we use also set orientation, we take here the plus x direction, and now we just get a little bit closer to select here this one and this one. And you can already see, if you go to the object view, that now this tool data one is a little bit, well, we want to have the approach axis in X, so we might want to change it again. So if we go back to the parent mode, not to the object mode, sorry, and we're going to turn it so that the plus X is in the approach axis. Here we go. Select, put it to 90 sharp, and here we go. So we have the X axis, the approach axis, and to I did the Z axis to the lower side, the Y axis, so here to the gripper jaws. Do we have here some mass inside this tool data one, which is actually predefined with 10 kilograms, and we also have a center of gravity and inertia. If you use your own gripper, you might want to fill in these values that you get from your CAD program, as they really impact cycle time that the robot is using. So make sure to also use the real values for the inertia and the center of gravity here. Now let's continue with the home position. If I go back to jog, I now want to actually go to the world coordinate system and define the new position of my gripper, which is now a little bit randomly here inside this ready to educate cell.
You then go to the jog, click on the jog, you can grab the different arrows and push it around in the room and position the robot as you are pleased. Another method that I'm going to show right away is actually to change the coordinates in this world coordinate systems. So here, for example, you can just type in minus 90 degrees and here 0 for B. C, you can set it to 180 degrees. Z, you can set it to 1200. And the Y coordinate systems to 500, and the last one, the X coordinate system, you just set it to minus 250 And now actually the robot has a nice orientation and we can touch up with a right click on the home position and click on touch up and it will set this position. Now, if you reset the simulation, you will see that actually the robot jumps back into this Canon position, even though you saved the home position. Why is that? Because actually the simulation behind that doesn't know the home position. And then if you start the program, it will actually slowly move to my saved or touch up home position. Do you see? It goes down and actually then runs the code. But if you want to start the program from here, you have to reset the simulation, click on the home position and then select this little arrow below the gear to the settings and actually click on that and click on the save state button. And if you do that and reset the simulation, the robot will stay at in the position as your home position. And if you run it, it will actually stay in the same position. And if you have other points in the program, it will run this code and program. I hope that you enjoyed the first part of the video. There is more to come where we're going to program a little bit here, the cubes that we're going to take out of the simulation and the pens. So stay tuned and see you in the next video.
Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to see more interesting videos about KUKA's simulation world, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Looking forward to seeing you in the next video.
Industrial intelligence.